Dude, imagine a world where like we're born like genderless, like. Fuck gender, like just imagine like it's a baby, bitch. It's not a boy, it's a girl. It's not a boy or a girl. It's just a baby. But Jasmine, you look so cute. First of all, yes. What do you have to say to your new fans?
Follow me on Instagram.
Follow her on Instagram, everyone. Thank you, Jasmine. Sorry about that. They literally only gave me four things to fucking play around with. But Jasmine, you're cute or whatever. All right. So I think it's time. I'm waiting for my cue. Oh shit, bitch. That's Cora. Just in case I get exposed, like Bretman Rock didn't tell the fucking story, or I did, like shit, you know, bitches be getting exposed nowadays. So, we have a motherfucking wheel out here, and we're gonna spin it, and whatever it lands on, I'm gonna be telling the story. So there's crazy fans, YouTube drama. I really don't give a fuck about YouTube drama, honestly, I mind my own business. My virginity and heartbreak, yeah. So let's spin the motherfucking wheel. Oh, heartbreak. Oh, that's a boring one. Okay, this is about my parents' divorce, but let me cover my virginity story first, because this is really short. And I want you guys to know about it, because it happened here. Like, that shit... underrated. Alright, so let me set the scene. Let me set the motherfucking scene, bitch. Once upon a time, I went to Disneyland. I know. It started at Disneyland. But it started outside of Disneyland when you check in. And... bitch! Alright, so my friend had not drugs, but weed, and we were going to Disneyland, and then, so they were like, Bretman, you have the fucking biggest bag, let's put it in there. So my dumbass, I was like, alright, whatever, it's just a fucking Disneyland. I didn't know that they actually check your bag at Disneyland, which I don't live here, I don't know. So they checked my bag, and I put it in my makeup bag, so the whole time I was like, ugh, I have so much makeup in here, like, you don't have to check, it's just makeup. And this bitch was like, oh, open the makeup bag. And oh my god, I was like, bitch, my heart was fucking beating so fucking fast, but she got no idea. So I was like, oh wait, let me put this aside real quick. And right when I put it aside, I opened the makeup bag. When I tell you, it smelled crit, bitch. It smelled crit. Oh my god, the whole place smelled like weed. And she was just like, bitch, there's weed in there. You're either gonna put it back in your car, or we're gonna have to confiscate it. And I was like, bitch, this is a lot of weed, and it's not even mine. It's like, I'm not gonna drop it. So, I was like, oh yeah, we'll put it back in the car, but bitch, we didn't bring a car, we took an Uber there. So we hid it in the bushes, and when we got back, the bitch was like, we saw you put it in the bushes. And I'm like, bitch, how? And then they were like, oh, we were watching on CCTV. And I was like, how the fuck? Like, y'all got CCTV in the bushes? Like, shut the fuck up. Like, you know damn well we didn't have a car. Like, shut up, you're not that bad. So, yeah, we were just like, okay, fine, you can have it. So we went to the bush, we grabbed it, and they were like, this is too much. But I was just like, bitch, you wanted the weed, like, get it, like, shit. So, we get to Disneyland, and I was just like, oh my god, I lost my weed. And I almost went to jail. So I went back home. And when I went back home, I was feeling some type of way. Not horny, but like, just some type of way, you know? And I'm so sorry, I know there's like little kids out here, so I'm not gonna try to, she's a real classy lady, so I'm not trying to be raunchy. So I'm gonna try to explain the birds and the bees, but this time it's just two birds and a big fat motherfucking bee, bitch. So, you know me, you know us gays, we have an app, not gonna say that no free promo grinder. It was grinder. I know. I'm so bad at trying. Which I lost my weed. Like, give me a break. So I was on grinder and I heard a little boop, and I was like, let me check this shit. So he was like, I'm not gonna say his age, but it starts with 20. not 12. Okay. I'm like, 20. Just 20.
20.
Just 20. So, how do I put this like without saying wrong, like raunchy thing? So he pulled up. We got it popping, bitch. We do what we have to fucking do, bitch. You know me. I was just like, how the fuck do I say this? Like, it was basically a point of the fucking entering a fucking act. Bitch, his dick was big. Like, when I tell you, I felt every motherfucking inch. All I'm gonna say because there's 10-year-olds here. So let's just talk about my parents' divorce. I fucking love talking about my parents' divorce. It's the funniest divorce you've ever fucking known in real life. Okay, so ew, I can't believe I just told you guys how I lost my fucking virginity. Ew, I lost my weed out this man. So, my parents' divorce. So my sister, my brother, and my mom were moving to Hawaii, and my dad, his ugly ass, he was like, oh, leave a child behind just in case you fucking cheat on me. Bitch, this bitch ended up cheating on my mom, but that's that point. I was the middle child, Bretman motherfucking rock, and I was left behind. And a week later, my dad hired a lesbian maid, and this bitch, my dad, he's kind of smart, so he made her like wear like a hat everywhere she goes, just so she's a fucking lesbian. My dad is a fucking dumbass. Like, just because you wear a hat doesn't mean you're a fucking lesbian. But it's not. So my mom, of course, she believed this. She's very naive. She was in Hawaii. We moved back to my mom's place. Now at my mom's place, it was a 3-bedroom house. Everything was empty. So there was no fucking point of us like having to sleep in one fucking room. Like imagine sharing a room with your maid, your dad,
it's a joke,
and yourself. Like why?
Huh?
So we would go to bed, my dad, me in the middle, and the maid. Tell me why I'd be waking up and I'm on the side like dying, like fucking on the edge of the fucking bed. My maid's like all up in my fucking dad. Like, but I was second grade at the time, so I really didn't like bother. Like, I didn't fucking know, I didn't care. So one day my mom called, ring, motherfucking ring, and she was like, bitch, what up? And I was like, hey. And I was second grade, so I really didn't know what I was talking about. So my mom was like, oh, how's the maid or whatever? And I'm like, oh yeah, dad loves her. Like, they're always kissing, and like, they're always massaging each other, and like, like, dad gets her everything, like, she's just so nice, but bitch, her breath fucking stinks. My dad would just fucking grab everything for her. Like, if she was hungry, my dad would grab, have food, like, right away. But if I was hungry, bitch, I have to wait the next day, like, I was starving. So, I was just like, bitch, I was petty. I was like, yeah, like, her breath stinks, like, she kisses me every day before school. And my mom was fucking pissed, bitch. My mom wasn't broke, but she wasn't the richest, but she was broke. So she fucking booked a flight back home to the Philippines the next fucking day, bitch. And that's fairly impossible, but my mom did it. Now this is where the story gets interesting, because this is when I find out that my mom is a fucking bad bitch, and that's where I got it from. Because my maid, when my mom got to the Philippines at our house, we live in the mountains. I'm Igorud, by the way, I'm Ilocano. Shout out to my Ilocanos out there. But my mom, my maid was cooking something, and my mom walked in, and I think my maid was cooking like fried fish. Dude, I'm not even wearing shoes. Oh my god. It's kind of hot. Sorry, it's hot. I put my towel. So hot. Sorry, where was I? Oh yeah, she was cooking something, and my mom grabbed the pot and poured the oil all over her left hand, and yeah, it's lit, bitch. It was fucking lit. If you saw this in person, it was fucking lit. So her hand was like boiling, bitch, like to the point where it was like 3rd degree burn. I was like, that's my mom. And my fucking dad, she chose her side. He grabbed like the toothpaste and like started rubbing it on her. And then my mom was like, who the fuck? Who the fuck do you think you fucking are? Like, in Ilocano. I don't know how to fucking say that in Ilocano. It was like really fast.